Welcome to the Rugged Rundown, and today what I'm going to talk about is the five things that I found out that I really don't like about the Getac K120 fully rugged hybrid laptop. This is the answer to Panasonic's Toughbooks CF33 fully rugged hybrid laptop. So you'll see a lot of similarities, but basically the five things that I found and I agree with, I read a lot of reviews and I recreated the problems, is number five is going to be the battery life. So let me show you the battery real quick so you can understand what I'm talking about. Pull this off and we just release the battery. Now you can see how small the battery is. These typically don't hold up well to high usage environments where you're using a lot of open programs, maybe running video and that sort of thing. So I can understand the problem. I did recreate it, and you know, it is an issue. But bottom line, all laptops in high usage situations are gonna have a problem with battery life. Number four on the list is touchscreen sensitivity. Now, if we take a look here, this is a fully rugged laptop. That means the screen is fully rugged. Yes, the touchscreen is going to be non-responsive. I've recreated it. It is true, but it is the case in every fully rugged laptop that I've ever sat here and reviewed with you guys, is the touchscreen sensitivity. So is it a real problem? No. It's as good as it gets. Number three on the list is the touchpad. Why is it always the touchpad that comes up on these fully rugged laptops? Yes, the touchpad, you have to press down, and that's because it's a resistive touchpad, not a capacitive touchpad. Read my blog, I'll put the link down in the description. I explained to you the differences between a fully rugged resistive touchpad versus the capacitive. Basically, you've got to actually push down on it for the mouse to respond for you. Number two on the list is audio quality. Again, yes, I know, on a fully rugged, you don't buy these units for the audio, but this audio is pretty bad. I've played music on it, listened to some YouTube videos, and yes, the audio needs some work. I feel like other fully rugged laptops have a little bit better audio system on them. But again, you don't buy this unit for good audio. Number one on my list, which is kind of an interesting one, which is overheating. When I read these reviews about the K120 overheating in high usage areas, it is true. I did get the fact that whenever it's stressed, it does get a little warm, but it never shuts down, which tells me that you're good. The processor isn't overheating to the point where it has to shut the laptop down so it doesn't damage itself. So yeah, that is a problem, but on these kind of laptops, you're going to have that kind of situation in every case. So I do have some bonus items that I found a problem. One of them is the latch. I find the latch is, if you take a look here, you can see the latch kind of lifts up like that and then springs back. Spring gets a little weak. I don't know how well that's going to hold, but right now it's holding. But if you look, I don't know if you can see it, but when you pop it out, it's kind of, I don't know. The latch is a problem for me. That is one of the items that I didn't particularly like on this unit. But that's my bonus one, so let's call that number six, right? Anyways, that's all I got for you today on the issues with the K120. Leave your comments down below. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys next week.